Good evening. We're delighted that you joined us tonight for our CM Christmas concert. Before we delve into the music, we kindly request your cooperation with a few important things. Please take a moment to ensure your cell phones and electronic devices are silenced. We also kindly ask for your commitment to maintaining a level of quiet and respect throughout the entirety of the concert. Picture, if you will, instead of a gymnasium, a concert hall, or cathedral, where every note can be heard, enhancing the spirit of the season. It's crucial to recognize the dedication and hard work our students have invested in preparing for tonight's Christmas performance. Since late October and early November, they've been working on this music, and we're so proud of their growth and accomplishments. Last, we'd appreciate your cooperation in refraining from using flash photography during the concert. Feel free to take non-flash photos at any time. And right now, we'll begin the concert with the percussion ensemble. doing, whoa, sorry, that was, I don't like, while they're doing this transition, moving equipment around, I want to give you a little bit of a intro to the next piece that you're going to hear, because you're going to recognize it, but what you need to know is that what you recognize it from isn't where it began. So this next piece that you see in the program does not look recognizable by the title. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about it. It's inspired by a traditional Sami, what we call a yoik, which is from the people of Scandinavia and Russia. Typical of this tradition is the use of short little melodic phrases that repeat endlessly with small variations. Since we've been rehearsing this, I've been calling the, you're gonna hear the tenors and basses start with the yoik. I've been calling them the yoikers during class. So we're gonna open with that. You will recognize this piece, which was made very famous in the movie Frozen, but it didn't come from Frozen like many of us think it did. It came from this old Scandinavian tradition. So once, I think we just have a few more things to move and we're gonna get started on this piece. I would ask if you're on the upper balcony, there's gonna be some movement, please stay seated. Otherwise, the students aren't gonna know exactly what to do. So students, if you can get into place up there, please.
Yeah, we have 10 minutes. I grip when I'm coming in to get the I So that piece was called ElfCon 5, and if you could imagine it, it came down to the elves working in Santa's workshop, and they realized the presents weren't loaded, and that's a problem. So it's kind of a catastrophe, and then it all comes together at the end. This next one is Not So Silent Night, and this is what the program notes say. Every child imagines what it might be like to observe Santa Claus coming down the chimney, delivering presents under the tree, enjoying milk and cookies, and so on. This programmatic work imagines how a movie soundtrack to such events might sound until things don't quite go as planned. Our scene begins as Santa descends down the chimney, careful to observe his new surroundings and not wake the home sleeping residents. Delicately, Santa begins his careful dance of tiptoeing around the home, humming Christmas tunes under his breath. He carefully places the presents under the tree, pausing briefly to ensure he hasn't awakened anyone. Slowly, Santa feels more and more comfortable with his surroundings, becoming less and less aware of how much noise he's making, and eventually breaking into full-throated merry singing as he goes about his work. Suddenly, Santa becomes very aware he's not the only one in the room. Around the corner peers a newly awakened pet dog, and not a friendly one. Panic sets in as Santa collects himself, and a full-blown chase ensues as Santa races for his exit. After a prolonged chase around the house, Santa makes his way up the chimney and out. With a sense of relief, Santa and his reindeer fly off to the next house where further antics no doubt await in what has become a not-so-silent night.
Thank you. Thank you.
So while we're transitioning for our final combined piece, a few people we'd like to thank. We'd always like to thank during this holiday season our custodians. That crew sets up and tears down, not for our concerts, not just our concerts, but also the Trimpy concerts and all the elementary programs. So can we give it up for our custodians? Our Tri-Am students also, this is one of their biggest projects throughout the entire school year, setting up and tearing down for all concert programs. So we thank our Tri-Am students. Shout out, oh yeah, go ahead, clap for them, they need it. I have it in my notes for every concert, and for some reason I always forget it, but a special thank you to Mr. Cocker and to Gannon Meyer for videotaping and live streaming these performances. And we hope you've enjoyed our CM Christmas concert. We're going to end on a combined piece that I believe Ms. Marshall might be turning around and giving you some cues to join in if you feel so inclined. On the first two. Here we go.
Thank you. Tonight.